Today in the grain market, corn was lower, filling the gap that it created last week, and then some. The market really started to build a little bit momentum on the downside, so it looks like the easy money is pretty much in the rearview mirror. The option volume and volatility both jumped up, with the 525 and 530 calls trading almost 8,000 contracts. So there's a lot more activity in the options. Of course, it's a great risk management tool. Even though we did expect this pullback in the market, the focus now is going to be mainly on demand and weather as we move forward into 2021. Now, soybeans did fall today as well. The futures did enter a full out correction. We're 84 cents off the high that we had last week, and we gave up a lot of the gains that we had made from the January USDA report. The CME margins have been increased as well, but that didn't necessarily have an impact on this market. Overall, the volume is up about 21%, so there's quite a bit of activity. Even the volatility in the futures, in the options, are up 5% for the February options. They're up to 27.5% right now, and they expire this Friday, so we're going to be watching that. The 1420 and 1450 options did trade a total of 3,000 contracts. So there's a little bit more scrambling and more activity in those strikes, and we expect that to roll over into the more deferred markets as well. So I think that now that we have a two-sided market, there's a lot more transaction and really a lot more trade action. Now, wheat was lower today. The futures did cool off somewhat, with the volume decreasing about 22%, which was kind of a surprise. But the corrective trade action is down now for the third day in a row, and really for all the commodities, they have been down 3 days in a row. We haven't seen this since last November. That just tells you how the uptrend has been really straight up for the last couple of months. The world markets just seem to be shifting from weather to demand, and that's kind of impacting U.S. Grains right now. But we could actually benefit, because the higher corn prices means that the feed demand really starts to shift over into the wheat market. So we're going to be watching that a little bit. With the wheat, $8 and 820 calls, traded almost 3,000 contracts. There's a lot of two-sided trade. Now, the grains overall continue to face tighter supplies ahead, and corrections like this normally seem to strengthen a bull market. So that's something to be watching as we go forward.